Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Please have a seat. Thank you.
My fellow Americans, tonight we're going to take a slight detour from our normal State Union address. Before I begin speaking on a range of important issues currently facing our country, such as immigration reform, battle against ISIS, ending the war in Afghanistan, skyrocketing price of Ben and Jerry's, and the plummeting price of tofu, I'd like to offer some thanks to the hard-working American men and women who make this country great, those ever-important people in our workforce who strive to deliver projects on time and on budget. That's right, our project manager. So this one's for you, PMs, and particularly those of you using Microsoft Project Online. See, ever since my staff began using the Microsoft Enterprise PPM tool, we began to notice gains in areas such as data visibility and task accountability. And we also experienced a major increase in overall team collaboration and work efficiency. It's been great. In some cases, we've even been able to reach across the aisle and bridge the bipartisan divide using this tool. Kentucky Senator Mitch Actually McConnell agreed with me that this increase in party collaboration broke new ground. So tonight, let's focus on this collaborative aspect of the solution. And because users who are now new to Project Online may struggle to get that first project site up and running, or to find the means to customize their project site template to better suit their team's needs, I'm going to show you how to get started. All right, here we go. Now, if you don't have administrator privileges, you're going to need to work with your admin to tackle these steps. But for those of you who do have proper system authority, start at your PWA homepage. Click on gear icon in the upper right and select site set. In the site collection administration section, click on site collection features. Now, you see down there in the list where it says SharePoint server publishing infrastructure? That's right. Is yours activated? Well, if it is, you're going to have to deactivate it. Yep. Now, I know what you're thinking. It ought to be done already for you. But in your case, it wasn't. So deactivate it. You'll get a warning message, and when you do, don't worry. Just click deactivate this feature. Alright, whether your feature was already deactivated, or you just deactivated it, it's time to move on. Go back to PWA, click the gear icon again. Fine, and click on PWA settings. Now, click on Connected SharePoint Sites. This shows you a list of your projects and their associated collaboration or project sites. If you don't have any projects showing, well, you're going to have to go create one. But we don't have time to wait on you to go and do that. So you'll just have to come back to this recording later and finish up. Those of you who do have at least one project showing, please continue with it. We're going to need a site to start. If none of your projects have a site, create one by clicking in the site address box associated with one of your projects and click the Create Site button. Excellent. Now, everyone should have a site to start. Find one and click on it. Let's put it in edit mode by clicking the Page tab and then Edit Page. Now, you SharePoint wizards can make and save any number of adjustments to this page. Just hit stop editing when you're done. And so all your site customizations you may have just made can be automatically included with sites created for any new projects. So you're going to want to save this site as a template. Click the gear icon again, and in the site action section, click the save site as template link. Please take note, you won't find this option if you fail to make that deactivation I spoke of earlier. Anyway. Enter a readily identifiable name for your template, like Project Site Template V1, for both the file and the template name box. If you included any documents or artifacts you want present with every site created, be sure to check the Include Content checkbox. Click OK, and when it stops working on it, click the next OK. Our final step is to tell the system to use this newly created site when creating new projects. Now, you can have a project site that's unique to every enterprise project type you have configured in your system. You can do that. It's up to you. But I'm only going to show you this for one enterprise project type. When you get the hang of it, you can perform these steps in repetition for additional ones. All right. Click the gear icon one last time. Find and click PWA settings. In the Workflow and Project Detail Pages section, click the Enterprise Project Types link. Find the EPT you want to tag with the site template we just created and click on its link. Scroll to the bottom where it says Project Sites Template and click the pick list to locate and select the site you just created. Click the Save button and you and your team are on your way to experiencing a greater sense of project collaboration with every new project you create. Well done, America. If you have any additional questions before we start the State of Union, please do not try to contact me at the White House. You likely will not be able to get me on the phone. My suggestion for you, rather, would be to get in touch with the good people over EPMA. They're the experts who implemented the system for my staff, and they can surely get you and your team wherever you need to go.